Hey, welcome back to my channel. For today's video, we're doing something just a little different. Nothing too out there. We are shopping the products that I recently pulled during my most recent Shop My Stash. So, shopping my shop stash. I want to put a face together for you and chat a little bit, so this makes that a little bit easier. Let's go ahead and get into the products that were pulled during my Shop My Stash. I have several primers to choose from. Most of these were left in my Shop My Stash from the prior month because they never got used. I'm gonna pull the Tatcha Silk Canvas for this one. For foundation, I'm gonna pull the Hourglass Foundation Stick because this one was gonna get decluttered. It's rather old. I haven't used it in a very long time. I had this in my last month's Shop My Stash and I never used it. So today is gonna be like a final hurrah. If it sucks, if I don't like it, I'm going to go ahead and declutter it. It probably needs to be decluttered anyway, because I never really got any good use out of it. It's just not a product that I got on with very well. And I'm hoping, that with your skin changing over time, maybe I'll like it a little bit better now. Hopefully, this full face isn't a total bust because of that foundation. The next product, let's pull a concealer. This Physician's Formula, the Butter Glow, is a brand new concealer to me. Makes me a little nervous to pull it, but let's do that. Let's give that a try. I think we're gonna mix that in with the Pat McGrath because I like that one okay. And this one's super light, so hopefully that'll work out. I'm also gonna, do I wanna pull the Chantecaille powder? I'm gonna pull this to use as like a finishing powder once my whole face is done to kind of smooth over everything. But I'm also pulling my Fenty Beauty powder because I need something to actually set that foundation stick. I have oily skin, so that's why I don't typically wear a lot of foundation sticks or cream foundations, but the Pro Filter powder should help set it pretty well. So let's pull that. Do I want to try this Gigi Gorgeous powder underneath my eyes? I'm a little nervous about that. Let's do it anyway. We're just pulling out all the stops today. We're trying some stuff. Let's pull you. Haven't used you in ages. I think I want to pull this. This has a cream contour product in it. I think I want to pull that since I'm using a cream, a foundation stick. Let's do that. I'm still going to need like a powder bronzer though. I think I want to pull this Bare Minerals bronzer in Faux Tan. Let's pull that. It's been a long time since I've used that. Well, I guess before I pull blush, I need to know what eyeshadow I'm using. I want to try to give this Glam Light Icing Eye Primer a chance since I haven't used it yet. I've had it for a long time. Let's see. I think with this video, I'm going to do a palette bingo for my eyeshadow just to make it a little interesting. Why not, you know? I want to use one of these palettes because I haven't used them at all. And they're beautiful. Like, look at that. By the way, that was the Stone and Rock. This one is the Jewels and Gem. I kind of want to go with the Stone and Rock palette. I can't help it. I'm a sucker for these grungier greens, the mustardy tones. They're so pretty. Let's pull that. I guess it's already pulled. It's already in my stack here. What else do I need? I need blush. So because I'm doing something a little bit more, well, here, let's pull it back out. But I would say probably something not real bright. They're all very similar in tone. They're very peachy, but I think that'll go well with those tones of eyeshadows. Oh man, I really wanted to use this. This isn't gonna match. Nope, that's just not gonna work. I don't think that's gonna work. Shoo doggy. No, that's not gonna look great. Another day, Natasha. I did not plan that. Sorry. Yeah. Yeah, that'll work. Which one's that? Sandy Cheeks. All right, Melt. It's your time to shine, Sandy Cheeks. What else? I'm a little hesitant to use this again. I kind of put this in my Shop My Stash just like as a last hurrah. And if it doesn't work out, it's going in the trash. It's kind of old. It's a little bit dry. Oh, do I want to use that? No, you know what? Let's try out the Believe Butterfingers. Let's try out the Believe Beauty. It's like a fiber mascara. Is that it? Oh, highlighter. What highlighter do I want to use with that? And actually, I think I'm going to pull Bare Peach as well. I can top that off with this one because it's pretty similar. I usually do double up just because it makes my makeup last longer. I pulled Ray Rider from Kaleidos. I pulled the Laura Mercier highlighter. And I have Champagne Pop, which is in a million pieces, so I'm not going to open that. But I have to remember the tones of the eyeshadow as well. I'm thinking we'll probably go with Ray Rider. So I'm going to pull that for now. I think that's it. And if I'm not feeling Ray Rider, I can always use my Anastasia Glow Kit because there's four different tones in here. And I think one of those at least will go with the Odin's Eye palette. So, alrighty, let's play. All right, so we have our little pile of products sitting here in front of me, and I just want to play. I want to get started. I want to chat with you. I want to forget this ponytail ever happened. It looks rough. All right, first going in with the Tatcha Silk Canvas. As I said in my Shop My Stash, this is like a little, like, sample size version that I've had of it. It was nearly empty. And then I had these other little samples that were in these little tiny blister packs. I probably had 10 to 15 of them, and I just took it all out and mushed it all in this one little sample jar here. So it's full. It's got quite a bit in there. This is not like a favorite product of mine. While everyone else was losing their shit over it, I was trying to understand like what the hype was with it. So not really sure why I keep it, you know? Like, why bother? I just like trying different things from time to time, and somehow I feel like over time my opinion on things will change, and sometimes it does. So that's why I've kind of hung on to it. Maybe my opinion will change. Highly doubt it, but you never know. It says to use a rice size, like a grain of rice. That's how much you should use of this for your whole face. I don't know how, because that is not humanly possible. Did it do anything? I mean, my face feels nice and smooth, and I used a very minimal amount. I almost feel like I need to put on more. I just don't want it to be greasy. So I'm not gonna do anything else. I'm gonna leave it there. So before we get into this Hourglass Vanish Seamless Foundation Stick, I'm gonna take the Becca Under Eye Corrector underneath the eyes. This is something that I have to use. I have to. My under eyes are dry. I'm getting older, almost 40. So I need something to add some moisture to these under eyes. Like, I realized when I was on vacation how much hair and fuzz. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to get you all to see it. It is disgusting. Can you see it? It's pretty blown out because of the light. You don't want to see it. It's nasty. But we're gonna throw it underneath the eyes. A little bit of fuzz and hair never hurt nobody. So how is everyone doing? I haven't done a chatty get ready with me in a little while. Just because, I don't know. I feel like it's just not a video that does very well here. So I stopped filming them a whole lot. I like filming chatty get ready with me videos because I like talking to you all and having conversations in the comment section. It is one of my favorite things about uploading videos to YouTube. I've said that before. It still rings true. There are a solid group of people that I know will be here almost every video, if not every video, and I love chatting with you all. You all are my people. So don't think for a minute that I take that for granted, because I don't. I get excited when I see that you all have commented and we get a chance to talk. It's my favorite. So let me know down below what is new in your all's lives. What's going on? Everyone doing okay? Are we enjoying summertime? Does it feel like summertime? Because it sure as shit doesn't feel like it here. Well, some days it does, but then other days it's 40 degrees outside and it makes zero sense. I just put my window units in this past week, or the week before, I'm sorry, which is crazy. Usually they've been in for a few weeks by now. It's just this weather is all over the place. Okay, now that the Becca Under Eye Corrector is on, let's take the, is it the Vanish? Yes, the Vanish foundation from Hourglass. I can't talk, and I feel the fuzz under my eyes. Wonderful. I took Luna, which is our newest addition. I took her to the vet this morning to get spayed. And I cannot explain to you how guilty I felt taking her to the damn vet to get spayed. I shouldn't have felt guilty, but I did, because I know what that shit feels like. Because I just had a hysterectomy in January. So the whole time I'm talking to her on the way to the vet, and I'm like, I'm so sorry. I know. I feel so terrible. And she's crying the whole way there. So that didn't help either, making me feel guilty. So I'm really curious to see how this wears now because when I first got this foundation, I was not impressed. And I've probably only worn it a handful of times since. I've had it in my shop, my stash, numerous times, but then never wore it. It's not something I can wear to work, and that's typically when I wear the most makeup, is to work. This will not wear long on me. I'll be lucky if it wears a couple hours. So let's start off with that. I feel like that's a solid amount, and then we'll go from there. Definitely gonna use a brush for this. So yeah, Luna's at the vet. I'll be picking her up. I think she said after 3. After 3 and before 5. And I just feel so bad for her. I took off work today and tomorrow. That way I can be here with her because you really should be, kind of supervising your animal after they get spayed or neutered because you don't want them to bite at their stitches or be too active and rip their incision open. And maybe even just for like emotional support, you know what I mean? So, again, I know what it feels like to have that operation done, and I'm very grateful I had somebody here with me, so I'm gonna be here for my girl. And I'm so glad that it's getting done because let me tell you, when she's in heat, holy cow, all she does is cries and meows and whines and puts her ass in your face. And well, not my face, but the other cats. I have two male cats as well. So they get a face full of booty. And they don't like that shit because they don't know what to do with it. They've both been neutered for, a while now. So they're like, what am I supposed to do with that? Like, what do you want me to do? Get your ass out my face. So yeah, I'm excited she's getting fixed. Getting her vaccinations. We've only had her a couple months, so she still needs to get like her rabies vaccine. So she's getting done up today. Now, see, this looks pretty nice. It's way too light, obviously. I got a little bit of a tan at the beach. Not much, but enough to where this looks pretty ghostly. And I think I used the right amount this time. I think normally I was going in with way too much. And that's probably why I hated it so much. Oh, I can feel the fuzz. Oh, no. Honestly surprised at how good this looks considering it's pretty old. Probably shouldn't have it on my face, to be honest, but y'all know I like to live on the edge. I think another reason why I wasn't totally sold on this one is because it settled in all my lines and wrinkles. I'm getting older, I'm not in my 20s anymore, damn near 40. I'm gonna build this up just a little bit so I can hate myself. I just want a little bit more coverage around the redness here. So we just got back from the beach a few days ago, and we had such a good time. It was so nice having all three of my kids with me and just relaxing and enjoying each other's company and being at the beach, It was really, really nice. It's been years since all three of us were able to be at the beach together. It kind of stinks because we had that weather advisor or like the air advisory while we were there because of the fires in Canada. I mean, obviously, it didn't suck as much for us as it does for the people in Canada, so I don't want to downplay. Their experience, but my experience, we were only at the beach for 4 full days, and 2 of those were ruined because of the air quality. We weren't really able to do much. It rained 2 of those days, so we had like one really solid full day of sunshine where it was nice. It was like 78 degrees, beautiful weather, and that's when I got my little mini tan. I sat out for about 2 hours, about an hour and a half, something like that, and got a little tan. I can't sit out there long because I'll burn, so I'm very fair. And skin cancer is something that my mother fights with constantly. She's had numerous skin cancers removed from her face, her head, her neck. So I'm very cautious when it comes to being in the sun, because I ain't trying to deal with that when I'm, older. This does look really nice, though. Just a little pasty, that's all. Once I get to like the powder and the bronzer and all that stuff, it's gonna warm things up anyway, so we'll just see how it goes. So for the concealer, I bought the Physicians Formula Butter Glow. So this is new to me. I don't know how this is gonna work. It's very light. Like very, very light. So I know it's gonna be a little stark underneath the eyes. But I also pulled out the Pat McGrath Labs Divine. What is this called? The Skin Fetish Sublime. I don't know where I got Divine from. The Skin Fetish Sublime Perfection Concealer. Too many words. Too many words for a product. But anyhow, I'm going to mix these two together. Hopefully I can get them to work. So my oldest child graduated from high school last month. And I'm so proud of him. He's going to be a pharmacist. He actually works in a pharmacy now as a tech. And that's kind of what sparked his interest. Oh, this is going to be really light. I think I put too much. Shit. I do it every time. But anyhow, I'm really proud of him. And I'm excited to see what he does. And how his college experience goes. I got my other two kids. One of them's working. One of them just turned 15. So they're doing their own thing. And it's just weird because I'm used to being the only person, how do I want to put it? Not the only person in their lives, but I'm used to being like their main source of everything, whether it's entertainment or, you know, someone to hang out with, someone to do things with, or as they've all gotten older, you know, they all go their own way. And it's just weird because they're at that age where they're all kind of starting to do their own thing. And, you know, I'm used to them coming to me for everything. And it's so weird, especially my son, my oldest, he's almost 20. But, like, he's an adult now, you know? He's, like, doing his own thing, and he doesn't really need me for anything anymore, and I still have the urge to text him, like, when he doesn't come home, because I'm like, are you okay? What are you doing? Like, how are things going? Are you all right? But I have to remember, like, he's an adult, and I just need to relax a little bit. It's just hard. And then with my soon-to-be 17-year-old, same thing. Like, he's not quite an adult, but he's definitely not a child anymore. He is way more independent than, well, I guess I was probably just as independent at that age. I didn't want to be home ever. I wanted to be at my friends' houses and I wanted to be out doing things. I couldn't stand to be still. I couldn't stand to be cooped up in the house, and he is the same exact way. And now I'm opposite. Now I just want to sit at home and relax. And but it's just weird. It's weird being on my own, I guess, and having time for myself and not having to constantly tend to children. You know, as they get older, they don't need you as much anymore. So it's just weird having to come to terms with that, you know? Like, I don't know, they're all off doing their own thing, and I'm kind of sitting here like, now what? Like, what am I supposed to do? Like, when you're a single parent, and I've talked about this before, it's such a weird thing when your child or your children finally, like, grow up and start doing their own things, because you're kind of, like, left within an identity crisis because you're so used to identifying as the single mom, as the caregiver and the parent, and it's really hard to find your footing after your kids start to go, like, move on and do their own things. It's hard to figure out who you are again without young children, you know? So that's kind of where I'm at in life, is like, I need to figure out me again. I need to start doing things that make me happy and start having my own life without my kids. You know, they're all going to be grown in a couple years, and I need to learn how to live with that. It's just hard. It sucks. But it's also really cool because, and I was talking to a friend about this the other day, but I'm not even 40 yet. I'll be 40 in November, and all of my kids will be over the age of 18 by the time I'm 43. And, like, that's cool to me because I got to grow up with them, and I got to experience their childhood through a different lens, you know? And I think the experience would have been a lot different had I been a lot older. So I'm not mad about it. I'm excited that, you know, they're getting older and I get to kind of do my own thing. But it's also sad because I'm used to identifying that way and I'm used to living through my children, you know? They're my entire world, so now I have to figure out who I am without them. It's going to be interesting. Okay, so that doesn't look too bad. The concealer, it's definitely not my favorite. I mean, I can see it's bunching a little bit, and that might be because I use too much. And it's not covering as much as I would like, but it's not horrible. It's not the worst combo I've ever used. And it's not too bad, like it's not super full coverage to where that looks terrible. So, okay, I can live with that. We need to add some color and some warmth back to this face. So far, I am not mad about the foundation. I can see it bunching, you can really see that line. That is my main gripe with cream foundations, stick foundations, is that they settle in those lines and wrinkles terribly. I was just looking at Botox providers this morning. I've never had Botox filler, anything like that before. I've never had anything done. And I think I'm finally at the point where I'm heavily considering getting Botox. For the forehead, for these stupid 11 lines. I must frown a lot, I do. I do that because I can't see half the time. So I'm like squinting. And man, those lines are pronounced. So I want them to go away. Kindly. And I want these forehead lines to go away. Not much I can do, I don't think, about the, what do they call them, the marionette lines. And that's okay, you know. I'm kind of like, it is what it is. But this up here I would like to change. So I pulled the Vanity Makeup Sculpt and Glow palette. It's a trio of contour shades. Well, contour, brightener, and then you got a highlighter here. I typically just use the contour shade. It's a really beautiful, neutral, kind of, I was going to say gray leaning. It is a little bit, but it's the perfect tone for my skin tone for contouring. So that's what I'm going to use. I'm really excited to get into this eyeshadow. I want to do this palette bingo. I've only done a palette bingo once, and it was a collaboration I did with a good friend of mine, Debbie. I'll link the video above if you want to go check it out. It is an older video, like way older, and we were using a palette from a brand that I shall not name, that I don't purchase from or support anymore, but I had so much fun filming that video. And you know, I really enjoyed the fact that it was a collab with her, so I'm not going to private it or get rid of the video by any means. If you want to check it out, you're more than welcome to. It was fun, and I'm excited to do it again. Taking that contour shade, let's give me some cheekbones. Let's get some color back on this face. Instant. Bam. Love that. Oh, might have grabbed a little too much on that one. That's okay. We can blend her out. It's almost given like this pink undertone to it, right? I don't know if that's like my skin peeking through or if it's from the contour, but I really like that. I forgot how much I liked that. I haven't used this in a while. See, that's why it's nice to dip back into older products and remember how much, you know, you liked them and how good they are, because you start trying newer things. Well, I'm speaking for myself. I start trying newer things and then I forget about all the good things that I had or have. I love doing the Shop My Stash series. You all really seem to like it too. So I'm glad that I've found like my people, I guess, you know. I'm not buying as much makeup as I used to. I'm still buying some. I'm not going to lie to you. Okay, obviously. I bought the Odin's Eye palettes and some other stuff. I still got to keep it fresh by buying some newer stuff, but I'm not buying like I was. Where, you know, before I was doing like ranking my new makeup purchases. I was buying that much during the month that I could rank 30, 40 products. That's, I just can't. I can't keep up with that. I don't want to keep up with that. My collection is already overflowing to the point where like I can barely fit one more blush in my blush drawer or one more contour bronzer shade in that drawer. So I want to whittle it down to the stuff that I love, and this is how I do that. I do it by constantly using these products, getting a good feel for them. Plus, you know, when it comes to sharing my thoughts on products with you all, I would much prefer to share something that I've used over and over and over again, something that I have formed like full opinion on, not something I've tried once or twice and was like, yeah, I had good experiences those one or two times I tried it. I would rather share stuff that I know how it works, and I've used it in a variety of ways, you know what I mean? I just feel like these types of videos, using products that I already have and that I've used a million times, that's way more helpful than a first impression or using something once or twice and then telling you what I think about it. So I still like doing those too from time to time. Like, that looks kind of nice. I'm not even gonna lie. Now, a lot of this glow is gonna disappear when I use the Fenty Beauty setting powder, but I have to. I have to because of the oily skin. You all already know, it's just the way it goes. Aw, the vet just called. Her surgery went well. Oh, it makes me so relieved hearing that. I'm always nervous. Because you just never know. I mean, complications can happen just like they can happen with humans, so I feel so much more at ease knowing that she's good. But they have to monitor, of course, for a couple hours, make sure she's good. Once I'm done filming this, I'm gonna go pick my baby up. So I think I might have told you all this before, and I'll see if I can insert some pictures, but she's a snuggle bug. She likes to snuggle with me every night when I go to bed. Like, I lay on my side when I sleep, typically, and she'll come and walk right up against my chest and flop to where her back is towards me, and she lets me spoon her. I wrap my arm around her and everything. It is the cutest thing in the world, and I love it, and I'm glad that I have a snuggle partner now. I am the cat lady.
and I don't even care.
Okay, we need to move on to the blush. I'm digging this so far. I'm liking the glowiness of it, even though we're going to lose that. Actually, I need to put something underneath the chin here because of this whiteness, I guess, from the foundation. I'm going to contour a little bit under the chin and under the neck. Oh, that'll work. That looks so much better after blending that down the neck. Okay, the next product we're going to go in with is the Melt Cream Blush Light in Sandy Cheeks. Just a really beautiful, kind of a deeper, peachier shade, but with the eyeshadow palette I'm using, I figured this would be a good tone to use, so that's what we're doing. So I haven't talked about health stuff in the last couple videos just because I got so tired of talking about it all the time. It had literally consumed me. My health stuff was always the forefront of my mind in all my conversations, including here on YouTube. And I think when you do that, you're kind of setting yourself up for, I don't know, like everything was so negative all the time. And I just, because I felt so bad all the time, it's all I could think about. And I don't want my channel to be reflective of that. I want this to be a positive space for me. And I want to have fun over here, and I want to have fun with you all, and I don't want it to be a depressing place to be every time you come to my channel. So I might share things from time to time, you know, going forward, but I don't want my entire channel to be about nothing other than my health, because I don't think y'all want to see that, and I really don't want to talk about it all the time. So yeah, I'm just glad I'm kind of finally out of that phase where every single conversation was about my health. It's depressing, man. Physically, I do feel better than I did. I'm definitely not like 100%. I'm not completely free of all the stuff I was dealing with. I still have a lot of digestive problems, and I think I'm learning how to live with them a little bit better. So I'm managing things a little better, which is good, which is awesome. But I do have some days that are just rough, and there's not much I can do on those days to minimize the symptoms and to feel better. So I just have to kind of deal with it at this point. It is what it is. I've tried altering my diet. I've gone to so many doctors. I've had all kinds of tests, procedures. Like, I've done the work, and I'm just now at the point where I guess I'm accepting it just is what it is. My digestive system hates me, and I just need to be nice to it. So that's what I'm trying to do. This is really pretty, by the way. I like the tone of this. It's a very pretty peachy shade. So I had my hysterectomy at the end of January. So now it's been a little over 4 months ago, and I definitely feel like I'm completely healed from that. It took a while. It took a lot longer than I thought it was going to. And I think it's just because of things being compounded, you know, with all the other health crap. I think that's why it took so long. But I'm so glad that that is done and over with, and that I'm feeling better, because I think that that was causing a lot of problems. And I don't think I realized just how much it was affecting my overall health. So having that done was like one of the best things that I could have done. And I'm very glad I did it. So I would highly recommend, if you're somebody struggling with a lot of female issues, like heavy bleeding, you know, a lot of pain in your lower abdomen, get it checked out. You just never know what it could be. And I was shocked when I heard, like, of all the stuff that was going on with my lady parts. So I'm glad that I had the surgery and that I'm feeling much better in that regard. Plus, no more periods. I mean, you can't be mad about that. All right, does that look even? Man, that looks really nice, right? Digging it. Okay, way too much. I need to back off that a little bit. For right now, I'm just trying to live a little bit and not stress about my health and not have a million doctor's appointments every week, because I swear to you, there for a solid couple years, I felt like I had a doctor's appointment every week, if not multiple, and that's exhausting. Like, every day off, I had an appointment. I had to request a lot of days off because of appointments. And it wasn't just me. Like, I've got kids I have to squeeze in there too with their stuff, with their dental appointments and their health stuff. And it's like, it was a lot. So I'm just finally at a place where I feel like I'm managing things okay. And I just don't want to go to the doctors again anytime soon if I don't absolutely have to. That's where I'm at with that. And now we're going to move on from the health stuff. So the next thing to use, I guess, will be setting powder. I'm going to take the Fenty Beauty Pro Filter Setting Powder. I haven't used this in a really long time. This used to be my holy grail until they came out with the Huda Beauty setting powder. The only thing I don't like about this, it makes my eyes water terribly. And I don't know why. It's just a setting powder. But it does. If I get it anywhere near my eyeballs, they will water instantly. So, speaking of underneath the eyes, I forgot that I also pulled this GG Gorgeous setting powder, or touch-up powder is what it's called. I'm going to set the under eyes with this. I mean, just being real, the under eyes don't look fantastic anyway, so. Not terrible. Definitely not a fave. I don't know that I'll keep using it, but it works for today's look, so we're going to move it along. I'm going to take my e.l.f. face brush, and we're going to set this mug very well. Otherwise, this isn't going to wear very long. Do I need to tap out any lines first? Let's do that first. Oh, the other thing about this powder is it floofs everywhere. Every time I use it, it looks like there's a cloud of smoke hovering around me. But it does a good job. It sets. It sure does. It's just way too easy to breathe it in. I cannot be healthy. I forgot how much I like this setting powder, though. It does a really good job. Very smoothing. I like that. I do need to kind of go back over some stuff, though, just a little bit, because setting that heavy always takes away some of that color. So I did pick out a powder bronzer. You know what I forgot to do? Forgot to use the Blendiful. Dang it. Next time. I'm not going to do it now. It doesn't make sense to. So the powder bronzer I pulled is from Bare Minerals. This is their Endless Summer Bronzer in Faux Tan. And this is a very... I was going to say an old product. It is. This is a throwback if I've ever seen one. So this was something that I was inspired to purchase by Taylor Wynn. She used to be known as That Tayla. This is an older product. Powders are just one of those things that, like, I don't want to say they last forever, but a lot of them last a very long time. A lot longer than what the expiration date is. 12 months? Yeah, okay. I'm not saying it's safe to use it that long. I'm just saying that I don't really pay attention. Don't pay attention to the expiration dates. Maybe I should. All right, I'm going to use this to warm up just a little bit since we lost some of the color. I used to really like this bronzer. It's definitely pigmented. Good enough. Back away before it gets completely out of control. It is a little bit more warm than what I typically like, but it's still pretty. And now I'm going to take the Burt's Bees blush. This one is in Bare Peach. And I'm going to use that to top off the blush because it's peachy and it's beautiful. And it does have a slight sheen to it. So what else? What else can we chat about? There's really not been a whole lot going on otherwise. Just been working like usual. I have been filming a lot more, which makes me happy. Because, you know, when I was sick, I wasn't filming literally at all. You know, I would get up on certain days and I would want to film. And I had it fully set up that I was going to. And then I would start feeling like trash and I wouldn't be able to. So I'm really excited that I'm feeling at least well enough to film more often and feel like myself a little bit. Ooh, that looks nice. So let me know down below what kind of content you all would like to see from me. It's just been such a long time since I've had consistent content here that I'm not even really sure like where to go with things. The Shop My Stash series, obviously, we've already talked about this. That's not going anywhere. You all really seem to like that. So I'm absolutely going to keep filming that kind of content. But if there's anything else you all would like to see here, let me know and I will definitely take it into consideration. I don't like promising that I'm going to do anything because I've done that before and then it just doesn't get done because things happen. So I just want some ideas. If you all see other creators doing a certain style of video that you would like to see me do, or maybe you have an original idea, drop it down below. Let me know. I got a little heavy-handed with the peachy blush, okay? But it looks beautiful, so I'm not mad about it. I'm going to take Ray Rider from Kaleidos on the cheekbones for my highlight. I think this will go really well. And then we're going to get into, well, then I'm going to do the eyebrows off camera because you all don't want to see that. It's a tedious process. We'll come back and then I'll get into the palette bingo. I'm so excited to do a palette bingo. I just hope I get complimentary shades, that's all. Hope it doesn't do me dirty. Ooh, I haven't used this highlighter in a really long time. That's beautiful. Wow. Kaleidos knows what they're doing with their highlights, y'all. You haven't tried them out, you should. So, that's where we're at with the highlighter. I love that. That's so pretty. And it makes me want to use it more. I just forget about things. When you have so much stuff, you forget. Like, look at that. It's juicy. I love it. Okay, I'm going to hop off here and I'm going to do the brows. I use the same set of products that I always use. I didn't pull any special products for the Shop My Stash. I just need the brows to look okay. The rest of the face can look questionable. The brows have got to be on point. So I typically use, well, I'll just tell you real quick. I got a little chilly, so I threw a robe on. That's the other thing, man, these hot flashes. I thought that we were done. I thought I was done with them because things started to level out. No, we're not done. They are still in full effect. And they freaking suck. So as I was saying, I still use the same handful of products for my brows. I didn't pull anything special for this Shop My Stash just because the brows, they need to be on point. You know, I need at least one portion of my makeup routine needs to be okay. And it's got to be the brows. So I always use the same products. The Benefit Gimme Brow. I've been using the Benefit Gimme Brow since I started first really getting into makeup. So it's just a go-to product for me. I love it. It works well. I also use the Brow Gal Brow Pencil. Specifically in the shade Espresso, which is number 2. And then I also use the shade Chocolate, which is 03. It's just a really good brow pencil. The shade of the pencil is what I like the most. I like being able to sharpen it because I get a really fine point on it to make little hair strokes. I also use the Huda Beauty Bomb Brows, and I use the shade Medium Brown, which is number 5. Works well, has a super fine point on it, which I love for the hair strokes. I also use the Urban Decay Brow Blade. It's a process. All right, if you want to see an updated brow routine, let me know. I'll film it for you. I have a video I filmed a couple years ago doing it, and it's not that much different now. So if you want to see how I magically have brows, let me know and I'll film it for you in the future. But yeah, the Urban Decay Brow Blade, I use this because it is a pen, basically, a brow pen for the little hair strokes in the front. I give it some volume. Help to drag the tail out at the end, and then when I'm finished, I top it off with the Lime Crime Bushy Brow. Mainly because of the tone. It is a warmer color brown. I think this one's in brownie. Yeah. Just add some warmth to the brows because they're usually pretty dark, pretty cool toned by the time it's all said and done. That is the handful of products I use for my brows. So when I come back, that'll be applied, and then we can get into the palette bingo. I am so excited. Look, the brows are always a struggle, okay? So don't judge me. All right, I was going to go ahead and put on the eye primer, but the primer is something that I pulled for the Shop My Stash, so I wanted to share the process with you all. The eye primer that I'm using is a product that I pulled during my Shop My Stash. This is the Glam Light Icing. Mine is in the shade Buttercream, and it's just a light, I was going to say off-white, but it's more like a skin tone shade, like my skin tone, which is why I purchased it. I'm going to get that on the lids, and then we're going to start pulling shades for this palette bingo. Is this too deep? I mean, it blended in really nicely. Feels a little thin. I'm a little worried about this base. Have any of you ever done palette bingo before? To try to be a little creative and get a color palette that maybe you wouldn't normally choose. Let me know down below. And then if you have, what did you think about it? Did you enjoy it? Do you all enjoy watching these kinds of videos? I do. I think it really shows someone's creativity. And I think that it's interesting because it's usually colors that you wouldn't normally pair together. I mean, sometimes you get lucky and someone gets a really easy color story, but more often than not, you'll see colors paired together that you normally wouldn't see. And you have to be pretty creative with those types of looks. Because, you know, it doesn't always look fantastic when it's a color story like that. Yeah, I don't know if I like this primer. It's very liquidy. I just hope it works. I mean, it did a good job blanking out my lids. I'll find out when I go to put eyeshadow over top. Okay, I'm going to put up a random number generator on my phone. Well, I guess first I should show you what the palette looks like. So this is the Stone and Rock palette from Odin's Eye. Really beautiful. My main concern with this palette bingo is that I'm going to get too many shimmers and it's going to be nearly impossible to film a look with it because there's a lot of shimmers in this palette. Oh, I didn't really think about that before. There's 7 shimmers and 8 mattes. Where's my luck gonna be? Let's find out. So 15 shades total. Let's put it in. Okay, the name of this website is Calculator Soup. And it, oh, you all can't even see it. Oh, there it is. It lets you put in the minimum number, the maximum, no repeats, blah, blah, blah. So that's what we're going to do. All right, let's calculate. And it picks all five all at once. So calculate. Okay. There at the bottom, it shows the numbers. I'm going to read them out to you. Numbers 5, 15, 13, 3, and 1. So we got number 5, which is this really beautiful, deep hunter green. Number 15 is this really deep, dark, I was going to say black, but I think it's a dark brown. So far we have two really deep shades. Number 13, oh my God, is another deep shade, elevated. Oh, I'm in trouble. Number 3 is this really beautiful lime green. And number 1 is this white. So I had zero shimmer shades. They're all mattes. Are you kidding? Like, I gotta have a shimmer shade. Okay, let me swatch out the mattes on my hand. And I might pull one more in the hopes that I get a shimmer. Dang, seriously? And here I was worried I was gonna have all shimmers. So number 5. God, look how deep that shade is. Number 15, which is even deeper. Goodness gracious. Like, these are pigmented. Number 13, another deep shade. Number 3, thank goodness I have a lighter shade. And number 1, which is just a white. I don't want to leave it at just that, do I? An all matte look? I mean, that does push me out of my comfort zone. I don't typically do all matte looks. But I really want to get a shimmer shade in there, so I changed it to generate one number instead. Let's see what it gives me. Well, it gave me 15 again, so I can't do that. It gave me number 10. It's hard to see my phone. Number 10 is this one, lightheartedness. And let me swatch it. Still a very deep eye look. Pretty. I don't know that I would have chosen those tones on my own. Should I pull one more? Okay, I just need to stop and I need to create a look with it. All right, let's do that. So, looking at these tones, this is going to be interesting. I'm going to start by taking that lime green and I'm going to use that as my transition shade and I'm really going to like blow it out. So let's start there. Okay, dipping into Madness, that really pretty chartreusey type of green. It is a little deep for like a transition shade, so if I need to, I can blend it out with that white shade, Fervor. Let's scoot forward a little bit, shall we? See how well it works over this primer. I'm a little nervous. Kind of skipping a little bit. I don't know how I feel about this primer. It's almost like I'm having trouble building the color over it. And I don't think it's the shadow. I think it's the primer. It still just feels a little too tacky. And P. Louise is like that too. But when I use P. Louise, I do a very specific eye look. I pack color on. I don't really go in and blend like this. So maybe I should have done that with this. I just don't really want to do that kind of look today. I still got to go pick my cat up from the vet. I don't want to look totally glammed out. You know what I mean? Even though with this look, I'm probably still going to look pretty glam. I do love this green. It almost makes my eyes look blue. I had a subscriber comment that on my video where I did the Yucca palette that I had pretty blue eyes, and it's because of this color green it makes my eyes look blue. My eyes are actually green. I think it's crazy how eyeshadow can change the way your eyes look. Okay, we're gonna start there. So this color's been used. Man, I got some deep colors. I mean, it's really not a bad color palette to choose from. I think it goes together fairly well. The next obvious choice, in my opinion, is to take... I'm going to take this really... See, I'm very, like, the way I do my eyeshadow is very predictable, and it's just because I'm not that creative when it comes to building eye looks. I'm just not. I don't have the eye for it. So I usually do, like, light, and then I build up darker, then I put a shimmer in the inner portion of my lid. Like, that's just how I do it. But maybe I can do something different. I don't know. I'm trying here. Okay, I'm going to take that dark green. I don't know what else to do. And I'm going to start packing that here and blending it upward. This is such a pretty green. Yeah, I don't like how tacky this base is. I mean, those colors stick. Holy cow. Okay, I'm going to take a fluffy brush. This is the Refer 13, and it's just a smaller, fluffy brush. Lightly dip into that shade Cheer. This is the shade I'm using up here. And I'm gonna work on blending that into that lighter green. Gosh. I mean, that's pretty, though. Very beautiful shadows. They're blending really nicely. Starting to get a little dewy already on the forehead. I don't know, dude. I'm not liking the way it's blending over top of this base. The base is it's not even like tacky, it's wet. And I know I've said that, but it is. Even after I put shadow over top, it's wet. I don't like that. I don't know if it's like oily maybe? Like what is going on? I feel like it's making this eye look a lot more difficult than it needs to be. You can see it. Oh no. It's looking rough. I need to move on. This is looking rough. Like I'm not feeling that at all. That primer is not my favorite. I probably will not be using that again. I don't even know where to go from here. I'm scared. Okay, I'm gonna take Elevated, which is this deeper brown, and I'm also gonna pack that out there. I don't even know at this point. I feel like this is gonna be a mess. I mean, we going super smoky with it. Wow. This is definitely not the eye primer for you if you have oily lids. Wow. Ooh, I kind of like that. I do. It added the right amount of depth, didn't it? Hold up. Am I going to love this look? You never know. Sometimes it waits to the very end to come together. I feel like I did something funky on this side. What now? We still have the white, the shimmer, and the black. I don't feel like using that on the inner corner is going to be the way to go. Okay, I think what I want to do... take a trip with me here. What if I took the shade Passage, which is like that black shade? What if we tapped that on the outer corner lightly? I was going to use it as like for the lower lash line. What if we just tap it out here? Ooh, it's getting super smoky. Holy Moses. I don't usually do looks like this. Black can be very tricky to work with. Okay, well, and I still have to use white, and I have no idea where the hell I'm supposed to use that. Unless I packed it as a matte over the beginning portion of the lid, which I could. Let's try to do that. I don't use white a whole lot unless I'm like mixing it with something. Ooh, I mean, that's different. Still gotta use that shimmer shade. I mean, I'm not like hating the way this looks. It's just different from what I typically do. The only thing that I can think to do with that shimmer is to maybe pack it on out here a little bit. So let's try it. I don't even know. I don't even know what to do.
You can't even really see it because the colors out here are so deep.
It's coming across kind of like a toppery shade, which I guess works. I mean, it's different.
I don't hate it, though. It's just definitely not something I would have picked on my own, you know? That's the whole purpose of these kinds of videos.
Okay. I'm not mad about it. All right, I'm going to pack some of those shades on the lower lash line. I mean, this look is kind of growing on me a little bit. I got to be honest with you. All right, I'm going to dip into, I guess, Passage. We're just going to go full on smoky. What do y'all think? Do y'all like this? I'm going to keep this really tight against the lower waterline, though, because I don't want this to be super crazy underneath the eye. I got to say, these shades are so pigmented. But notice I had zero fallout, which is, thankfully. Now I'm gonna take my Sigma pencil brush. This is the E30. I use this every time I do my lower lash line. And I'm gonna smoke that out with Cheer.
And then I'm gonna take that lime green underneath of it.
Do I want to walk up in the animal hospital like this? I'm not sure.
It's a little extra. That's a lot. But hopefully this lighter green shade will lighten that up a little bit. With my Sigma blending brush, the E36, it's a very floofy but small head on this brush. I'm going to take that light green Madness and hopefully lighten this up underneath. If I have to, we'll take the white underneath of it too. I might have gone a little heavy underneath. Like mildly. I don't hate it. Easy way to cover up your eye bags. Wow. Yeah, this turned out to be a lot. Okay. I need a good mascara. I pulled the Believe Beauty mascara for this look. You know, at first, I need an inner corner highlight. I didn't pull one. This was all of the shades that I pulled. So I'm going to take Frenzy, which is this really pretty iridescent sparkly shade here. That's going on the inner corner because I said so. Ooh, I love that. That just added a pop of fun, didn't it? Do I want to risk it with the Believe Beauty mascara? Like, I need something intense with this eye look. This says it's a fiber mascara. I don't know. I might have to dip in my collection and pick something that I know will work. I can't have the mascara flop. Not with this bold of an eye look. Guess I can always take it off, right? If it doesn't work. Oh, wish me luck. It's a very wet formula. Please don't do me dirty. I mean, it's not awful, but it didn't do anything special. Like, I need some drama with this eye look, you know? I almost need falsies, but I don't wear false lashes, and I'm not going to start today. So, this mascara is going to have to do it. I thought fiber mascara was supposed to lengthen your lashes.
Because that's not happening.
Man, I got short, stubby little lashes.
That sucks. I don't feel like it did a whole lot, so it's pretty much performed how I thought it was going to perform. So, this is everything that I pulled today. Let me disappear and grab something for the lower waterline, something for the lips. I'll come back and we'll finish off this fun, dark, very intense look. All right, so to finish off this look, I did the lips, obviously, and I finished the lower waterline. For the lower waterline, I used the Beauty Creations eye pencil. This one's in Lime Time. Not really sure why it's called Lime Time, because it's yellow, not green. But anyhow, it did turn mildly green on my lower waterline because I think it got mixed in with the shadow. That's fine. It worked out okay. And then I took the OG, one of my very favorite lipsticks that you can no longer get. This is Rum Punch by Tarte. I wish they would bring this back. It's one of my favorite lipsticks. It just goes with so many different looks. It's a very beautiful neutral shade. Goes with this okay. I thought about doing something a little more like mauve toned, but to be honest with you, I need to go pick up my cat, so this is what we're stuck with. And I use the lip liner from the once KKW Beauty. This is kind of old. This one's in the shade Nude 0.5. Goes well with Rum Punch. And this is the finished look. So did you all enjoy watching the palette bingo? Because I had a blast doing that. And this is 100% not a look that I would come up with all on my own. I would have never paired these tones together. Well, some of them I would have, but not all of them. Never. So I think it's fun. It's very dramatic. I'm debating washing my face off before I go to the vet. Oh, I forgot to tell you. The Hourglass Foundation? It's beautiful. Of course it is. Of course it is, because it's expired and I should probably not put it on my face again. But I really, really like it. And I'm going to keep it. And I'm just going to take my chances, you know? Because it's beautiful on the skin. I think if you set your face well enough, it works, even with oily skin. I just think it turned out really beautifully. I don't know. I had a lot of fun. I had a lot of fun playing with the products that I pulled from my Shop My Stash. Let me know down below if you enjoyed it. Let me know if you like the eye look, if you want me to do more palette bingos. I would love to hear from you all. Thank you all so much for watching. If you made it this far in the video and you're not subscribed yet and you've been enjoying my content, please don't forget to hit that subscribe button. I would love to have you stick around, join the community. We just like to chat, talk about makeup, talk to each other in the comments. It's a good time. Let me know also anything else you'd like me to film for you all in the future. Again, I'm always open for feedback, and hopefully, with me feeling better, I will be able to film more going forward. That's the goal. Some consistency for a change here on my channel. So thanks again for watching. Like the video if you like it. Subscribe. I'll catch you all in the next video. Bye.